Hello children, in this video I am going to explain chapter 3 of 11th standard maths, that is trigonometric function. Now first I will start with its introduction. Trigonometry is a branch of mathematics that studies triangles and the relationships between their sides and angles. As you all know, because you have studied in 10th standard, trigonometric is the relationship between their sides and the angles. Now, we have also studied the trigonometric identities, that is sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1, and application of trigonometric ratios in solving the problems related to height and distance. In this chapter, we will generalize the concept of trigonometric ratios to trigonometric functions. Functions that you already studied in chapter 2, that chapter was relation and function, and study their properties also. Now, we have to start with the concept angles and their measurement. You all are well versed with what is angle and their measurement. Now, what is angle? An angle is the figure formed by two rays sharing a common endpoint. The two rays are called sides of the angle, and the common endpoint is called vertex of the angle. Just see here, this is your first ray and this is your second ray. The first ray, and then after rotation it will convert it into this ray. So this is your initial side and this is your terminal side. The common end point is called vertex. Now definitely the rotation will be anti-clockwise direction and clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise direction is your this is for positive angle, and clockwise direction is considered as negative angle. That means direction of rotation anti-clockwise is there, then that angle is formed plus theta, and here the angle is formed minus theta. Then after, we have to study units for measurement of angle. Okay, now there are two types of measurement of angle. The first one is degree and the second one is radian. First measurement is degree measure and the second is radian measure. Now what is degree? An angle is said to be of 1 degree, denoted by 1 degree. This is the sign of degree. If it is 1 by 360th part of a revolution. A circle, a complete revolution is there. So 1 degree is 1 by 360th part of the revolution. One revolution, one complete revolution is 360 degree. After degree, then minute is there. What is each degree is divided into 60 equal parts, called minutes. A measure of angle in minute is denoted by a single prime. This is the sign of minute. So 1 degree is equals to 60 minute. Then after seconds, each minute is further divided into 60 equal parts called seconds. It is denoted by double prime, that is 1 minute is equals to 60 seconds. The complete measurement is degree, minute, and then after second. The second measurement is radian. An angle is said to be of 1 radian, denoted by 1 rad, rad. It is termed as rad or 1 to the power small c. It is also considered radian. If the length of arc is equal to the radius of a circle, radius of the circle. Now consider, children, this is a circle, okay, and length of arc. This is your length of arc and this is your radius. When the radius is equal to length of arc, L is equals to R, then that formation of angle is called radian. Angle subtended by an arc of length R is equals to 1 radian. This is R and this is R, then it is called 1 radian. Theta is equals to L upon R, so R upon R is 1. And that is your radian measurement. Therefore, angle theta is equals to L upon R, so theta is in radian. Therefore, two types of measurement, degree measure and radian measure. Now we have to have some idea of relation between degree and radian. Consider a circle of radius R. Then angle in radian subtended by the circle at the center is given by theta is equals to L upon R. You all know theta is equals to length of arc upon radius of the circle. And length of arc is 2 pi R and R is this one. Cancelled, this is your 2 pi. Also, the angle in degree subtended by the circle at the center is 360 degree, which implies 360 degree is equals to 2 pi radian, because 2 pi is one revolution of a circle and here 360 degree is considered as one revolution. So both are equal. So 360 degree is equals to 2 pi radian. Therefore, 1 radian is equals to 180 by pi degree. Radian to degree. 1 radian is equals to 180 by pi. Here, we have to put pi is equals to 22 by 7. And 1 degree is equals to pi by 180 radian. Pi in radian is as it is. Okay, now. In 10th standard, you have studied 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree till 90 degree acute angles. So 0 degree is in radian 0. 30 degree, 30 into pi by 180, it will give you pi by 6 radian. 45 degree, it will give you pi by 4 radian. 60 degree, pi by 3 radian. 90 degree, pi by 2 radian. 120 degree, 2 pi by 3 radian. 135 degree, 3 pi by 4 degree. How you will get it? Multiply the degree, 135 degree into pi by 180, you will get this value. And so on, you can calculate for any degree measure to radian measure. Okay, now, area of a sector of a circle. You all know area of a sector. This is a circle R and length of arc L is there. Theta is the angle at O. So theta is equals to L upon R. Area of a sector subtending angle 2 pi is pi R square, square unit. Therefore, area of a sector subtending angle theta is theta into pi R square upon 2 pi. Pi and pi get cancelled. It is half R square theta square unit. Okay. Now, in exercise 3.1, I am going to explain two questions. Conversion, convert into radian to degree and degree to radian. Question number 1 in NCERT exercise 3.1 is, convert 25 degree and minus 47 degree 30 minute into radian measure. This is conversion from degree to radian. So since 1 degree is equals to pi by 180 radian, so 25 degree is equals to 25 into pi by 180 radian. It will give you 5 pi by 36 radian. Second question is minus 47 degree 30 minute. You can convert it into radian when these two units, degree and minute, be converted into only one unit. So 30 degree should be converted into degree. And minus is the sign of rotation in clockwise direction. Okay, so minus is as it is, and this is the measurement of angle. So it can be written as minus 47 degree minus 30 minute. And 30 minute should be converted into degree. How it is going to convert it? 30 into 1 by 60. Because 1 degree is 60 minute. So minus 47 minus half degree. Take LCM, then after it will give you minus 95 by 2 degree. Minus is outside because it shows the direction. 95 by 2 into pi by 180 radian. It is minus 19 pi by 72 radian. Minus 47 degree 30 minute is equals to minus 19 pi by 72 radian. This way you have to do third and fourth part of question number 1 by yourself. Okay, because I have explained two part of that question. Next question number 2 is convert 11 by 16 radian and minus 4 radian into degree measure. Now the conversion is from radian to degree. So we know that 1 radian is equals to 180 by pi degree, where pi is equals to 22 by 7. So 11 by 16 radian, it is equals to 11 by 16 is multiplied by 180 by pi. Pi is 22 by 7. Whole after doing calculation, it will give you 39.375 degree. Okay, and this 375 degree can be converted into minute. It will give you 22 minute and 30 seconds. So this is the complete conversion into degree, radian to degree. And the second part is minus 4. Minus 4, that means it is in clockwise direction. So minus be outside, 4 into 180 by pi, and pi is 22 upon 7. So after doing calculation, it will give you 229 into 1 upon 11. This is your mixed fraction. So therefore 229 degree complete number is the, and 1 by 11 is fractional part, therefore it is going to convert into minute. So 1 by 11 into 60 minute. So minus 229 degree, 60 by 11 is 5, whole number 5 by 11. So this 5 is your complete number and it is considered as 5 minute. So minus 229 degree, 5 minute. Now the fractional part is 5 by 11. It is converted into seconds by doing multiplication of by 60 degree. So 5 by 11 into 60 seconds. After doing calculation, the whole value is minus 229 degree, 5 minute and 29 seconds. Okay, this way you have to convert degree into radian and radian into degree. In this video, I have explained angle, measurement of angle, and conversion from degree to radian and radian to degree. Your homework is complete question number 1 and 2 of exercise 3.1. Thank you.